I believe Ryan's great-grandma was his biggest enabler over the years. Granny would spoil Ryan with toys and money. She would not hold Ryan accountable for anything. He could do no wrong in her eyes. Now my mom is taking over. My mom feels bad for him, so when he gets out of jail, she'll go pick him up, take him to friends' houses. Even my daughter Sheilagh will enable her brother. My mom and daughter will buy him food. They've also put him in a hotel room at least 10 times in the last 3 months. Ryan is a master manipulator. He comes off charming, so everybody believes what he says and does what he wants.
Heather says when she adopted Ryan and Sheilagh, her family agreed with her that they would raise the children as a team. But she says something went wrong because her granny Jean and her mom Kristi and even her daughter Sheilagh have all turned Ryan into a spoiled brat. Here's what Kristi and Sheilagh have to say.
My brother Ryan's personality has always been, it's my way or the highway. If he doesn't get his way, he throws a fit like a child.
I want my cigarettes.
Now, you're not getting cigarettes, you're not getting jacked. Did you hear me?
Ryan.
My grandson loves drama, and it goes along with Ryan and his entitlement behavior. If he wants to do something, he will find a way to engineer cooperation to get it done his way.
I've definitely enabled Ryan's lifestyle. I do wish I didn't sometimes, but I'm not gonna let him go without his necessities.
Sometimes I'm taking advantage with the money that you give me. I don't use it like I'm supposed to use it.
I talk to Kristi and mom and they're like, oh, we already got him food and stuff like that. And then I'm like, okay, well, I feel like he just scammed me, honestly.
I took mercy on him with the hotel rooms. I paid for his rooms so that he wouldn't miss court. If he had missed court, we would have lost the bail money.
Ryan talks about getting his own place, but honestly, none of us think that he'll be able to keep his own place without getting kicked out with all the alcohol and the screaming and the yelling.
She's nasty. She's foul behavior. Get her out of here. Get her out of here!
His temper has gotten to me when he drinks.
Over here.
Why am I over here? What do you think, Ryan?
I don't know.
I just told her you're not to be served here at 7-Eleven.
I'm not drinking alcohol. I just had a
Ryan,
cigarette.
I'm looking right at you. You're weaving.
Ryan's mouth can also get him in a lot of trouble. He told me that he was getting food and some guy just randomly punched him in the face. I'm pretty sure Ryan said a racial slur to the guy, but he honestly doesn't remember.
It breaks my heart that he doesn't care more about himself. I fear he's just gonna end up being a sewer rat or dead.
All right, Sheilagh, Kristi, I'm glad you're here.
Thank you.
I'm not sure that this is gonna be easy for y'all.
No.
According to Heather, she and I've been talking and she says she's done. Mm-hmm. She says she's done enabling, she's done picking up the pieces. And what's more, and this is probably the most important thing, she's done feeling bad about whatever happens with Ryan. And I'm curious where the two of you are in this regard, because he's gonna come out here in a bit and I'm gonna talk to him. And I wanna know if you two are assets or liabilities for me, because my intention is to give him a damn wake-up call.
Yeah.
So where are y'all?
I feel bad for him and everything, but at the same time, I mean, maybe you can talk some sense into him, because I feel as a sister, I've done everything. Like, it breaks my heart, you know, he's...
Well, let me try to talk some sense to you.
Yeah, definitely.
You said you feel bad for him.
I feel bad for him.
What is it you feel bad for him about? He is a lazy suck mooch. He manipulates, lies, cheats, steals, takes from other people. What about that triggers compassion in you?
No, I guess I totally understand that and everything. I guess, I mean, just because, like, he's got really bad anxiety, and also that my great-grandma, or both our grannies passed away and everything, so it's just...
Cycle
I don't know, like,
life.
I feel... Yeah, no, and I understand that and everything. I guess I just, like, feel bad that, you know, like, he has to live this lifestyle. He feels he has to be, like, that
no,
social
doesn't.
Butterfly and everything.
No, he doesn't.
Yeah.
He doesn't have to live this lifestyle. He chooses to live this lifestyle because you give him money. You buy him food. You make it possible for him to do it. You make it possible for him to do it. She's made it possible for him to do it. You have all crippled him no less than if you took a bat and hit him in the knees.